How's everyone doing on this Tuesday? I'm hanging out over in Nampa, Idaho, waiting for my next appointment. And I just thought I wanted to talk about a little bit of a quote that I posted up earlier today. And the quote goes like this, okay? And it has to do with mindset, because I think that mindset is the biggest thing that helps people be successful in life. And I think that that's a big play in it. So there's two parts to it. The first part says, success comes to those who become self-conscious. So what that means to me is that success comes to those who become self-aware. You realize that your success doesn't depend on anything other than what you have to offer. The second part of that is, says, failures come to those who indifferently allow themselves to become failure conscious. So think about that. Failure is not a bad thing, okay? And I feel like a lot of people think that they're gonna get something right the first time and it's gonna happen no matter what. And I watch this with my six-year-old. I get frustrated because I can make baskets, right? I can shoot a basketball. But as a PE teacher, I know that she has to develop motor skills in order to have that fine motor movement, be able to shoot the basket, be able to bump a balloon up, trying to find those things that she has to do. And you have to start somewhere, right? And we always have this talk, you know, with her. And I had this talk with people who I taught as well, as they say, I can't do it. And I hate that word. I don't think can't should be a part of anybody's vocabulary. And what that comes down to is someone told them that they can't. And so they think that there's no way that they're possibly going to be able to do that. And that's all about mindset. So I can't do it now doesn't mean that I can't do it later. It means that I need to try more. I need to practice more so that I can have a positive outcome. And when you see that there is a possibility of a positive outcome and you continue to work towards that positive outcome, it's going to happen sooner or later. But it doesn't just happen overnight. When you put a basketball in a five-year-old's hand and you say, hey, put it through that hoop up there, and it's 10 feet tall and the kid's 3 feet tall, it's never going to go in there. It may get in there, but it's not going to look very pretty and he's not going to have very good form. He's just going to throw it up there as hard as he can and go in. So you have to practice and you have to hone your abilities, and that's what it comes down to. That's where it happens with anything. I go through this every single time I do an interview because I'm starting to get better at interviews and it's starting to become more and more fluid and more easy and more something that I do on a daily basis. I'm fine with talking to someone like this. Everything that I do, I love to do live videos because it's very authentic and I don't have to talk about it. I don't have to read off of a script. You saw me a couple minutes ago reading off a quote. I'm not very good at reading off of a quote. I'm a good reader, but I'm not good at reading off of a quote. So that's the same thing with posting, putting yourself out there, anything that you do. It's gonna take you putting in the effort. Now, if you have this mindset where you don't wanna put out the effort, or you feel like you're not gonna reap any rewards from not putting out the effort, then you're never gonna get what you want. People talk about reaching their goals. And if you look at it, if you look at anyone who has ever attained a goal, who has ever been successful in anything that they've done, they didn't get it the first time. Scientists go and create vaccines or try to create vaccines, and they've tried 90 different types of vaccines before they get the one. Millions of times, possibly. Anything that you do is gonna take time and is gonna take effort. And so I think the biggest thing that you need to realize is that your failure, if you continue to think that you're gonna fail, you're going to. But if you can see the end result of what you want and where you're at, it will happen. You will be successful because you're determined to continually fix that, to re-engineer what you're doing every single time to make the best choice to be successful. And that's the difference between a winner and a loser. Someone who doesn't reach their goals and someone who does reach their goals. I'm sorry, winner or loser. Loser has a negative connotation. That's the way it is. There are winners in this world, and there are losers in this world. There are people who try and continue to work hard no matter what. There are people who do not. There are people who go out and they swing a baseball bat at a ball over and over again and strike out 1,000 times, but then go in and practice and swing more and more and more and don't strike out. No matter what you do, the only way to get better at something is to continue to do it and to reach for the stars and reach for that goal and always have the idea that you may fail no matter what. Failure is not a bad thing, which we teach our kids all the time by handing them out all these trophies and ribbons and things like that. Failure is a good thing because it teaches you to power through so that you don't fail every single time. Think about that today. I hope that you have a great day. Remember, failure is not a bad thing. Think about the end result. Think about the positive outcome. Have a great day.